Hello everyone, welcome to day 15 of prelims warm up, where we are discussing the important topics for the upcoming UPSC prelims 2020. This initiative has been brought to you by Aptiplus Academy for Civil Services, and I am Shayak Datta, the faculty for Geography and Environment at Aptiplus Academy for Civil Services. So now let us start with the first question for today. So first question is, with reference to the Washington consensus, consider the following statements. First statement, it refers to a set of policy statements to support the Middle East crisis. Second statement, the policy reforms included 10 propositions that were thought to be good for the crisis-driven Latin American countries of the time. That is when the Washington consensus was signed. So this particular policy, it consists of 10 propositions which were considered to be good for the crisis which was facing the Latin American countries. And third statement is, in the coming times, the term became synonymous to market fundamentalism. Fourth statement is, the term Washington consensus was coined by the US economist John Williamson. Okay, so this is with regards to Washington consensus, and it is a part of your economics. So let us see one by one. The first statement, it refers to a set of policy statements to support the Middle East crisis. That is actually incorrect. But the second statement, the policy reforms include 10 propositions which were thought to be good for the crisis-driven Latin American countries of the time. That is correct. The third statement is also correct. Okay, later on, this particular term, Washington consensus, it became synonymous with market fundamentalism. And fourth statement, it was coined by the US economist John Williamson. That is also correct. So out of the given statements, we get to see one is incorrect. Two, three, and four are correct. I have given you some idea regarding Washington consensus over here. By the way, the answer is should be C, 2, 3, and 4. So if we look at Washington consensus, it was coined by the US economist John Williamson, and this was coined in the year 1989. And in this particular term, or in this particular entire set of policy, he had suggested a set of policy reforms which most of the officials in Washington, like say for example International Monetary Fund and World Bank, thought would be good for the crisis-driven Latin American countries of that time. If you want to know more regarding the Washington consensus, you can read up about it on this Wikipedia link which I have pasted over here. Okay, so this is the first question with regards to Washington consensus. Moving on to the second question, and this is with regards to the global geopark status. So the first statement says, once a UNESCO global geopark is always a UNESCO global geopark. So once a particular site has been declared as a global geopark by UNESCO, it will always remain as a UNESCO global geopark. That is the first statement. The second statement says that the Global Geopark Network is a legally constituted not-for-profit organization with an annual membership fee. And we have to select which out of the given statements is or are correct. So what is this concept of a global geopark? Basically, it is a site which is having geological importance, geological significance. And this particular area, it is protected. It is also used for sustainable development. It is also used for education purpose. So the first statement that you have, once a UNESCO global geopark, does that always mean that that site will always remain a UNESCO global geopark? Answer is no, that is not the case. Every 4 years, it is re-examined, okay, whether it is fulfilling the criteria for a global geopark or not. And accordingly, either the status remains or it is taken away. So the first statement is actually incorrect. The second statement is correct. So Global Geopark Network, basically it's a network of geoparks across the world. So the second statement is correct. Answer should be 2B. So answer is B. And here I have given you some idea regarding the Global Geopark Initiative. The UNESCO Global Geoparks, what are they? They are single unified geographical areas where sites and landscapes of international geological significance are managed with a holistic concept of protection, education, and sustainable development. So they are managed with these ideas, education, protection, and sustainable development would be carried out. A UNESCO Global Geopark, it uses its geological heritage in connection with all other aspects of the area's natural as well as cultural heritage as well, to enhance awareness and understanding of key issues which are facing the society, such as using the Earth's resources sustainably, mitigating the effects of climate change, and reducing natural disaster-related risks. By raising awareness of the importance of the area's geological heritage in history and society today, UNESCO's global geoparks give local people a sense of pride in their region and strengthen their identification with the area. This is what is global geopark, and the first statement is incorrect, as you can understand. Okay, a UNESCO's global geopark is given this designation for a period of 4 years. And after the 4 year period is over, the functioning and quality of each UNESCO global geopark will be thoroughly re-examined during a revalidation process. And if you want to know more regarding global geopark, I have pasted the link for UNESCO, so you can go to this particular link on your UNESCO's website, where you will get authentic information regarding UNESCO's global geopark. Similarly, you can go to this particular link as well to understand the various aspects of a global geopark. So please read up on UNESCO's global geopark initiative. The third question that we have is with regards to the novel coronavirus. So you have two statements. First statement is saying the novel coronavirus is also known as the Beijing coronavirus. First statement is saying the novel coronavirus is also known as the Beijing coronavirus. Second statement is saying genomic sequencing has shown that it is a DNA type of coronavirus. So first statement, novel coronavirus is also known as Beijing coronavirus. And the second statement is saying genome sequencing has shown that it is DNA coronavirus. And you have been asked to choose the correct statement. So let us see one by one. First statement, novel coronavirus is also known as the Beijing coronavirus. Now, though President Trump has been trying to blame China for the origin of this coronavirus, but officially it is not known as the Beijing coronavirus. On the other hand, since it had originated in Wuhan, Wuhan province of China, so sometimes it is also referred to as the Wuhan coronavirus. The first statement is actually incorrect. Second statement, genomic sequencing has shown that it is DNA coronavirus, so that is also incorrect because it is RNA coronavirus, ribonucleic acid. So your answer should be C, neither one nor two. Let us see. So answer is C, and this 2019 novel coronavirus, also called as COVID-19, okay, it is also known as the Wuhan coronavirus. It is a contagious virus. It causes respiratory infection, and it has shown evidence of human to human transmission, as we all are aware. It was first identified by the authorities in Wuhan in China, and genomic sequencing has shown that it is a positive sense single-stranded RNA coronavirus. Initially, we know the initial cases, it had links to a large sea market, something which is referred to as a wet market over there, an animal market, and the virus is thought to have zoonotic origin, though the link is not very clear till now. But sometimes bats and also other species are like pangolins are thought to be the origin of this particular coronavirus, but it has not yet been confirmed. So what are the symptoms? You have fever or fatigue or dry cough is also there, shortness of breath is there, respiratory symptoms are there. Plus you can also have other types of issues, for example, loss of smell, loss of taste. All these things are initial symptoms of the novel coronavirus COVID-19. Moving on to question number 4. Which of the following became the first state to adopt an automated multimodal biometric identification system? Automated multimodal biometric authentication system or identification system. And that is what is in short form is AMBIS. So you have A, Maharashtra, B, Gujarat, C, Punjab, and D, Haryana. So it is A, Maharashtra, which has adopted this particular AMBIS system. And going forward, maybe the other states in the country will also adopt it. So Maharashtra, it has become the first state in the country to adopt an automated multimodal biometric identification system, also called as AMBIS. So here it will be able to take the digital fingerprint, iris scanning, and that will also help in investigation, plus it will also help to quicken the entire process of identifying the person, knowing about their history of crime, etc., etc. And it will soon be replicated by police forces of other states in the country. So it's a very advanced system, and if you want to know more, then you can go to this particular link of the Hindu where it had appeared, and from here I have taken this particular question. Now moving on to the last question for the day. So the last question is, okay, you have two statements given, and the question is saying, okay, which of the following statements is or are correct about the quick reaction surface to air missiles, QRSAM. Quick reaction surface to air missile, also called as QRSAM. First statement, it is a missile which has jointly been developed by India and China, somewhat like BrahMos, that is what it is trying to mean. Second statement is saying it is an all-weather and all-terrain missile that uses solid propellant, and it has a range of 5000 kilometers. And you've been asked which out of these are correct. So if you look at the quick reaction surface to air missile, it was in the news, and it was in the news because, number one, it has been developed indigenously, not with the collaboration of India and China, India and Russia. So if you see the answer, you'll get to see that it is D, though neither one nor two, because first thing is it has been developed by the DRDO indigenously. And second thing is the range which was given. It was given as 5000 kilometers, but the range is actually 500 kilometers. Okay. So first thing, please remember QRSAM, quick reaction surface to air missile. It has been developed indigenously by DRDO. And it has a range of around 500 kilometers and not 5000 kilometers. But yes, it has a whole lot of other features as well. And to understand about those features, you can refer to this particular link of PIB. This is from where I've taken the question or the topic. So please go to this particular link, read up more regarding QRSAM, because UPSC frequently asks questions regarding new weapon systems, satellites, as well as things like this, missiles and all. So they frequently ask you questions from such areas. So read up on this and get to know the details regarding QRSAM. So with this, we will complete today's session of the five topics, most probable topics for UPSC Prelims 2020. So hope you have liked the video. And for more information, for more such important topics for the upcoming UPSC Prelims 2020, please do like, share, subscribe and comment on the video section, and keep following AptiPlus's YouTube channel. So till then, till the next session, take care and study hard. Bye-bye.